Hello, Sagittarians, welcome to your January 2022 general reading. Now, we will divide the reading into different sections so it is a bit easier to understand. And also, I usually get a bit more when I separate it, at least it's easier to understand for me. So we will be dividing this into the overall energy for the month of January 2022 for the star sign of Sagittarius before we then go into your emotional core, and that could be about trauma that needs to leave, that could be about love coming in, all that sort of stuff, before we then move on to the area of opportunity. And opportunity usually, because I only work here, I have no idea what the guides are going to say, opportunities is about what comes your way regarding what sustains you financially, if that makes sense. Now, this is the year 2022. Your governing planet, Sagittarians, is Jupiter. And Jupiter is a very outgoing planet, but for the first 5.5 months of the year 2022, your governing planet sits in the sign of Pisces. So what that means is, since Pisces is the sign of the dreamer, you will likely get much more vivid dreams because your governing planet literally borrows the energy of Pisces for the time he sits there, and vice versa. So I'm a Piscean, so things will probably be much stronger for Pisceans as well. In Sagittarius' case, you will very likely get much more vivid dreams. And also, since you are, well, presented or depicted by the archer is shooting the arrow forward strongly. And yet, just to say that, so you want to do stuff, you want to get going. And at the same time, since Jupiter is the sign of the dreamer, and the color associated with Sagittarius is purple, the color of the crown chakra. So, in short, what will happen very likely, or what will happen this year, at least in the first 5.5 months that Jupiter sits in the sign of the dreamer, is for you to understand and to be guided towards seeing things from a much more spiritual point of view, right? Just wanted to say that. Well, on the 2nd of January, we will have a new moon, so it's also good for you to actually keep manifesting stuff. And on the 4th of January, the Earth is closest to the Sun, which means we're getting an energy boost. So use this in January, right? So that was just a few things about astrology as it applies to Sagittarians in the year 2022 and January respectively. Now let's have a look at the overall energy for the months ahead. Let's see what we got for you. So you have unicorns and the pools of energy. You have unicorns and the pools of energy. I'm using the Atlantis deck by Diana Cooper for this month's readings. And what the unicorn literally means is, again, spirituality is deep understanding that you are a spiritual person that has a physical experience, for want of a better word. And because you have the unicorns plural, this month, January 2022, for the star sign of Sagittarian or Sagittarius, they really want you to see anything and everything spiritually. What that means is, because it's a weird word possibly, see things from a higher point of view. When anything comes your way, especially with the overall energy, you know, new year, new beginnings, a lot of people are all over the place. See things from a higher point of view, right? And detach yourself slightly, because that's how you ought to understand who is causing issues here, right? And do I really need to actually respond? Because your next energy for the overall energy for the month of January is pools of energy. So I already said that on the 2nd of January we have a new moon. The new moon is about new beginnings, but the new moon is also not illuminated. So from the new moon to the full moon, it will take 2 weeks. So when you plan new things, right? Keep manifesting them because the energy is stronger because of the new moon, but because light is coming in slowly, don't expect massive changes overnight, right? So don't be impatient at all, which goes hand in hand with the pools of energy, because what the guides are saying to you with the overall energy for your star sign for the month of January 2022 is that your energy will ebb and flow. There will be pools of energy coming to you. So there will be times where you feel like, yeah, let's kick some butt here. And when you feel that way, then do something with it. When you feel, all right, I feel like I need a break, I need a breather, then take a breather. Always trust, really, always trust what you're feeling and how you're feeling at any given moment. You don't owe anyone an explanation with regards to how you feel. You feel the way you feel and you should act accordingly, right? Excuse me. That's your overall energy for the star sign of Sagittarian for the months of January 2022. You are watching Energy and Star Sign Reading with myself, Thomas Janak. If you like my work, you can now support me by buying me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. That's buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. That was the overall energy for Sagittarians in January 2022. Let's have a look at your emotional core. Let's see what's going on and coming in there. And like I said, I'm using the Atlantis deck by Diana Cooper this month. Haven't abandoned my energy, my animal guides at all. And as you can see, there are animals here already depicted. Anyway, what you have is nature and excellence. Nature and excellence. I don't know if you can see this here. Nature and excellence. And it is in that order. What the guides are saying to you, remember we already talked about the overall energy, that you have pools of energy, so you don't have a 31-day energy like, right? There will be ups and downs this month. Also, how you feel with regards to your emotions, because that's the area we're in. So what the guides are saying to you, remember that our biggest ally is nature. And they want you to go and spend time in nature to actually recharge. And remember, your color is purple. You are all about the crown chakra. You're all about receiving knowledge and wisdom from the universe and understanding that you are literally, therefore, a teacher, right? And a healer. So what I'm hearing is for you to actually make sure that you understand things strongly by spending time in nature. And if you now think, crying out loud, I haven't got time. There is an old saying, I think it's in Buddhism, but it's an old saying anyway, where someone says, what should I do? I'm all over the place. And the guy says, sit every day for 20 minutes and meditate. And if you haven't got time, sit for an hour. What that literally means, Sagittarians, is you have to make time and commit to your well-being, right? Nobody can do this for you. Really, really important. So remembering that your governing planet, Jupiter, is in the star sign of the dreamer, also allows you to be sort of, sounds a bit weird, spiritually more connected to our ally, nature. So this is all, nothing thrives in isolation. So when I talk about astrology and your governing planet and stuff, it's all related and it all relates to you. This is part of your imprint, right? So because you have nature, that's where they want you to go. And the next energy here is excellence. So what they're saying to you is, in order for you to manifest properly, to actually also achieve things, when you actually connect, which also will bring about some healing here, excellence, whatever that means for you, can be achieved. So there's a couple of things that come up here with excellence. As you can see here in the depiction, right, there's a trinity of three people, right? So you don't have to go things alone. Excellence is also, just like perfection, oftentimes a man-made term, right? Whether or not people think you're excellent, makes no difference as long as you give your all to any given situation. Right? So don't allow yourself at any time to feel the pressure of other people's opinion, because it's just their opinion. It's quite simple, right? So excellence means that your energy can be super high regarding your love life and your letting go of trauma, if that makes sense, right? But you also need to understand that you are already, because that's part of what I'm getting here, energetically speaking, you may already be affected by old relationships. And they're not necessarily just talking about intimate relationships. They're just talking about whatever happened to you in this lifetime that may still sit with you, right? And so being in nature seems to be, energetically at least, the most important aspect here to deal with your emotional core, right? So that's that. Now let's move into the area of opportunities as they come your way in January 2022. In the background, you hear a noise. I have two cats and two litter trays, and one of them happens to be in the room where I do the reading, and I'm not going to tell my cat off, you know, just in case he needs to do a number two or something, right? So, shall we? Let's have a look at the opportunities as they present themselves to you in the months of January 2022. It is quite interesting here for Sagittarians, because with regards to opportunities, attracting new beginnings, attracting a way forward, you have water and technology, which is quite interesting. Water and technology. Let me say this again. You have water and technology. So what that truly means is two things. Number one, as a Sagittarian, right? You are represented or presented by the archer, so there is an arrow that moves forward. So you are a very progressive being by default, and because you have technology as the outgoing energy, what they're saying is maybe rather than just reading a book, which is always a good idea, right? If you are a person that is very old-fashioned, that sort of sits books and has candlelight, which is perfect because awesome and also very spiritual. In January, they're asking you to also look at how technology could help your life. Are there things that can make your life easier without having to give in to, you know, buying some really expensive machine somehow? But technology is important because it's also because you have water here, which means they're also asking you to renew. And so in order for you to manifest new beginnings, especially with regards to what sustains you financially, you need to, again, you know, renew yourself. Really, really important, right? And then you have technology. I don't know if you can see this here. There is these pyramids flying in the air and floating in the air. And literally, in translation, what that really means, they're not asking you to buy two iPhones and then just think that all of a sudden you get a text that there's a new job coming your way. Doesn't quite work that way. But understanding that when you are a progressive being, which is the nature of Sagittarius, it makes sense to look at how have we evolved, which technologies are we using, and what I'm getting is, because I do astrology, obviously, I'm getting the idea, very simple, is by you just watching documentaries about the latest technologies that bring us to the Pleiadians. You know, anything with having to do with exploring space is what comes to me here, right? So I have no idea if any of this resonates with you. This is a general reading. And because the Atlanteans have a very specific way of talking, and I try to explain this as best I can. Anything that comes here, they mean 150%. So when they're giving you as the outgoing energy with regards to new opportunities and it's technology, it could also mean that maybe you have to put the work in to be up to speed with whatever new technology is coming in wherever it is you work. Now, Sagittarians, make no mistake about it, because you're a progressive sign, right? And because you have been asked this month especially to understand that you are, how spiritual you are, You will likely be much better off, in a way, creating your own day, maybe being self-employed, and making sure that you can work at your own pace, because that's another thing that the arrow is saying to you. You decide how fast forward and how strongly you shoot the arrow at any given time. Guys, that was your January 2022 general reading for the star sign of Sagittarius. You are watching Energy and Star Sign Reading with myself, Tommy Sennack. Please like, subscribe and share, because that really helps the YouTube algorithm so people can find the reading. And it helps me grow my channel. And remember, if you like my work, you can support me now by buying me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. That's buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. See you all next month. Bye-bye.